A grand challenge in energy for the 21st century is how we store, generate, and use energy without the environmental impact and the concerns about the climate. At the heart of the problem is a materials problem. We've got to find the right types of materials that give us increased functionality, and we have to think about how we integrate them into devices and how we integrate them into our energy storage and harvesting components.
Smart energy is really a very broad term that we coined to include several key areas of research on campus. They're related to energy harvesting. For example, solar energy is very important. Another area is energy utilization. Then a third area is energy storage with things like batteries and supercapacitors. And that's the kind of research that Binghamton University is really excited about.
Flexible hybrid electronics make use of materials from both the traditional semiconductor world as well as from the printed and printed electronics world, and fuse them together to form high-performance devices that can be small and miniature, that use low power, and in principle can be worn. Could be worn by people on their bodies to monitor their health, or could be worn by structural elements such as sections of a bridge or propellers in a helicopter or other kinds of devices, maybe in a windmill, that could also be used to monitor their structural health and report back, you know, are the strains getting too high? Is your heart rate too high? Do you have certain kinds of biomarkers in your perspiration that might indicate a certain kind of medical condition? And so this really helps to motivate the need to make batteries smaller and to look at new ways. One, to make the device very, very efficient so that it uses as little power as possible. In addition, potentially to harvest the power from the source, whether it's a rotation from a blade or whether it's a pulse or a body temperature, there's some kind of a thermoelectric transfer of the heat energy to electric energy.
Binghamton has been able to bring together chemistry, physics, and mechanical engineering under the banner of material science and engineering. So researchers can work together, they can bring their teams together, and just good things happen when you can get collaborative efforts.
I'm working in close collaboration with a person in computer science, and my students have had the opportunities to interact with the students in his group and learn more about how to develop code in a professional way and how to package our product for being released as open source.
When I talk to prospective students, I tell them about the possibilities of these new technologies and how they'll have a role in developing them, not only from a fundamental material perspective, but also their fabrication, as well as working with an industrial partner so that they have a full picture of what it is to create, design, and develop new technology.
GE Global Research and Binghamton University have a long history of collaborating together in the electronics space, in the electronics packaging space. We work very closely with the university. We rely upon them for their deep expertise. We rely upon them for the facilities that they have in fabrication, in analysis, in reliability, and we've done this for a long time.
The interaction with students and postdocs at Binghamton University has been a critical element in our collaborations with them. They approach technical challenges with unique solutions or unique perspectives that enable us to identify new solutions to those challenges. Plus, also, it enables us to build relationships with them. So as they go out into industry, we've already had a productive relationship established for future collaborations or interactions.
When we collaborate with industry, we work on projects that have a potential deep and positive impact on society, very broad impact on society. And there's nothing more rewarding than that. If you work on something that you see over time people using and living a better life or having better health, there's nothing as satisfying as seeing that.
The growth of Binghamton University is one of the exciting aspects, and this gives us opportunities to provide the environment of a small university where you have that hands-on proximity with your mentors, but with the opportunities and resources of a larger university. Quite simply, Binghamton University is smart energy.